Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we will be testing solar panels. We'll be using a general purpose multimeter, and we'll also be using a specialized solar panel multimeter. The purists should love this. Let's get started. Okay, so these are the three panels we'll be testing. These two are identical in make and model. One has been used for about 8 months and one has been sitting in the garage, never used. So we're gonna see the difference between a fresh panel, never used, and a panel that's been used for a while. The panel over there is a smaller 60 cell panel, and we'll be testing that as well. And that's used, and it's probably about 5 or 10 years old. And I purchased all these panels at Santan Solar. Check them out, they got great prices on new and used panels. Let's quickly go over the stats of our panels. The larger panels are 335 watt 72 cell poly panels by Risen Technology, and I got them for $150 each, brand new. The third panel is a 250 watt Trina Solar / Santan Solar 60 cell poly panel, and I got it used for just $45, and I'm guessing it's between 5 and 10 years old. Last I checked, they actually went up in price by $20 since my purchase. I love these little panels. Let's talk about testing. First, locate the panel specs sticker on the back of your panel. Here we can see the sticker for the two different panels I will be testing. We can see that this is a 335 watt panel by looking at the rated max power value. This is in watts. All these values are important, but if you are using a regular multimeter, you will only be able to measure two of them accurately. The open circuit voltage, VOC, and short circuit current, or amps, ISC. Volts open circuit. This is the max voltage the panel can produce when not connected or under load, open circuit. Short circuit current, ISC. This is the largest current the panel will produce when short circuited. For example, if you were to connect the ends of the wires from the panels together, I means current, SC means short circuit. The voltage at Pmax and current at Pmax values are the max volts and amps the panel can produce under load, when the panel is in use, and in perfect conditions. We will see these values when using the solar panel multimeter. For best results when testing, follow these tips. Be sure to clean your panel before testing. Do your testing during high noon, when the sun is at its strongest. Make sure your panel is at the proper orientation and angle for your latitude, zip code, and time of year. There are many websites where you can input your zip code to find this information for your area. You can download a protractor app for your phone to find the degrees of angle. I have linked to one such website as well as the protractor app in the description below. I will be using the FrogBro EY800W solar panel multimeter. This meter can measure watts, VMP, IMP, and the VOC of your solar panel and display everything neatly in one place. We will cover these terms later. The EY800W can measure up to 800 watts of solar input. This is useful when measuring more than one panel connected in series or measuring very powerful panels over 400 watts. There is also a 400 watt version, and I just found out a new 1600 watt version as well, but at 60 volts max, kind of not useful. A multimeter is a general purpose tool for electrical work. The multimeter I will be using is a Klein Tools CL800 digital clamp meter, and cost around $130. There is also the CL390 and cost around $90. You can get a basic probe meter for less than $50. The Lamvam T28 is a good example. These meters are not specifically designed to measure solar panel output accurately, as solar panels should be tested under load. For this reason, I was not going to include using a multimeter to test panels in this video. However, I realize most people simply want to know if their panels are working or not, and are not interested in the electrical minutiae. A multimeter can certainly do this. When using multimeters, the A means amps and the V means volts. The solid line means direct current. The wave or sine line means alternating current. The small m means millivolts. You will not use millivolts or milliamps when testing solar panels. When using a probe-only meter, no clamp, you will swap the positive red lead to the A port to measure amps. On this meter, 20 amps max, as well as switch the dial to the A position to read amps. Solar panels produce DC current. For volts, swap the positive lead to the volts/ohms port and switch the dial to the V accordingly. When using a clamp meter, you will use the clamp to read amps instead. This is safer and generally can read a higher number of amps. When purchasing a multimeter, be sure that it can read direct current. It will either say DC or simply have the solid line you see here. Some meters can only read AC amps, especially with Klein meters. Be sure that the max rated input, amps, is higher than the short circuit current value of the panel you are testing. Be sure that the max rated input voltage is higher than the open circuit or VOC value of your panel that you are testing. A 10 amp meter should be able to handle most panels. Links for these devices are posted below. Okay, so before we actually put the panels in the sun and test them, I want to show how to actually probe the panels properly. Some panels will have a plug at the top, some smaller wattage panels with some MC4 connectors, and versus these ones which have wires coming off the back, and you'll just probe the MC4 connectors on the plug, the same as these. So this one is the positive, and this one is the negative. Positive, negative. All you have to do inside the connectors, there's some little pins in there. They're called ferrules. You just insert your probe into the connector. The red goes on positive, and the negative goes in negative. Also, as a side note, if you're using a probe meter, when you put the probes, because you'll also put the probes for amps and volts inside the connectors, you will get a bit of a spark, so don't be alarmed. It's perfectly normal. Don't test this at the end of the cable which goes into your charge controller, because you're going to have a huge number of amps potentially, and that's just not the proper way to do it when you're trying to test a single panel. Alright, so our first test is going to be the Trina Solar 250 watt panel. It's high noon here in Vegas and it's perfect testing conditions, no clouds. The panel has been cleaned and it is exactly at 13 degrees tilt angle. So let's just verify that with our protractor app. You can see we have 12, 13 degrees. Anywhere between 12 and 15 degrees is ideal. We're going to use the multimeter first. And then we're going to use our solar panel multimeter second. We're only going to use the multimeter once. There's no need to show it for the rest of the panels. I have a 10-foot extension cable so that we can read the screens on the machines over here in the shade, because you can't see the screens in the sun. Okay, so whether you're using a clamp meter or a probe meter, when we test the voltage open circuit, VOC, it's going to be the same. We're going to switch it to volts. Then you're going to have to select the function, because right now it's on AC volts. Switch it over to DC volts. There you go. And now we can do our test. So we're going to plug in the red to the red, and the negative to the negative, black to black. And we're getting 31.71 volts. Now this panel has a VOC of 37.6, so it's pretty close. All right, so next we're going to test the amps. This panel has a short circuit current of 8.85 amps. So to test the amps, you're going to switch it to amps. Now for a probe meter, you're going to have to move your red lead to another port to read amps. For a clamp meter, we'll just use the clamp. But we will still want to switch it to DC. And then hold it down to zero it out. Make sure your amps are zeroed out so it doesn't give a false reading. All right, so all we have to do to create a short circuit is plug the cables into each other, and that'll create a short circuit. And then put your clamp meter on the cable. All
All right, so this panel has a short circuit current of 8.85, but we're getting 9 amps. So that's kind of interesting. It's a little higher than, could be just our meter not exactly calibrated. But yeah, it shouldn't really ever exceed that rating. So that's interesting, but there it is. There's the amps.
All right, so next we're gonna use our solar panel multimeter. We're just gonna connect the MC4 connectors right to the MC4 connectors, very simple. So red to red, black to black.
All right, so we're just gonna do a manual pull. 198 watts, VMP, voltage max power is 22.57, current to max power is 8.78, and our VOC is 32. So from a 250 watt solar panel, we're getting almost 200 watts. Which, if you account for the cable length, is probably 200 watts, which is not bad for a 5 to 10 year old panel.
When using the multimeter, we saw an ISC of 9 amps and a VOC reading of 31.71 volts. But when tested under load using the solar panel meter, we only got 200 watts. If you were to try and calculate watts by multiplying these values together, we would get 285 watts, which is completely wrong. If we multiply the current at Pmax by the voltage at Pmax found on the sticker, we should get exactly 250 watts. These values are when the panel is under load, hence Pmax or max power. This is why panels need to be tested under load.
All right, next up is our 335 watt panel. The panel has been cleaned. It's at the perfect tilt angle. Let's just verify that. 12 degrees tilt angles, perfect. Connect up our meter. Okay, we're gonna do a manual pull, here we go. VOC is 40. Look at that, 300 watts almost. From a 335 watt panel, we're getting about 300 watts. So this is from a new panel, purchased new and used for about 8 months. VMP 30.74, IMP 9.54.
On this panel, we saw an IMP greater than the IMP Pmax value on the sticker. We can see that the panel has a VOC of 45.9 volts when not under load. This is due to the voltage drop when the panel is under load. The lower the voltage, the higher the amps will be, and vice versa when under load.
Okay, so I'm racing against that. We're down to like 1 inch. All right, so this is the new risen panel, 335 watt panel, just like the last one. But this is brand new, never been used in any capacity. It's been sitting in the garage. Let's test our angle. Okay, it looks like our angle is at 12 degrees, which is perfect. Let's see what we get. Okay, we're gonna do a manual pull here. VOC 43.329. Look at that, 322. So from a 335 watt panel never used, we gained 20 watts. So you can see when your panels are freshly purchased, you're gonna get more power. And then after, I don't know, several months or so, it'll decrease by about 10% or so. Okay, here we are at the test array. We have basically three strings in parallel. So those top three is one string. This bottom three right here is another string. And those three over there make up another string, and they're all connected in parallel. So we're gonna use the meters to test the panels when they're in series parallel configuration. All right, here we are under the solar panels. I don't recommend crawling under live solar panels, but I do it so you don't have to. They're currently not connected to the inverter, but they are still alive. Now, 2000 watts is too much power for the solar panel multimeter to test, so we're gonna be testing each string individually. Each string can produce about 650 watts at peak power. Each set of three come into this branch connector on its own line. And this branch connector is good for 30 amps. You don't want to exceed 30 amps on these branch connectors. Each line would produce a max of about 10 amps.
So like I stated before, you don't want to probe at your main lines. There's 30 amps right here, and if your meter is only good for 20 amps, you'll blow up your meter. Like I said before, the panels have to be under load, and right now the panels are not connected to the charge controller. So when using a multimeter to test a string of panels, you have to induce a load by other means, such as turning on your inverter or charge controller. So I'm going to go inside, turn on the inverter, and turn on a heavy load so we induce a load onto these panels. Okay, so we're pulling about 1500 watts out the panels right now. We've got our meter set to amps, and we're going to test the amps on each string. First string is producing 7.2. That's the top string up there. Second string is producing 9. That's almost max. I think that's this middle string, the one I'm under. And the back string against the wall is producing 6.8. So since we tested each string individually, let's test the main output, where all the panels are combined in parallel, and see how many amps we get. So here's the combiner, the fuse, and then right here we should have all the amps together. You can see we're reading about 20 amps, 22 amps. Now if you had a probe meter that has a limit of 20 or 10 amps, and you were to probe the ends of this cable, going to your MPPT charge controller, you'd actually destroy your meter. But a clamp meter can handle much more amps, so I always recommend to use a clamp meter. Handle more amps, and it's much more safer when testing multiple panels in series parallel. Okay, so now I disconnected the panels from the inverter, so there is no current flowing through these panels. We can verify that, 0 amps. So now we're going to use the solar panel multimeter to test these strings individually. And this is where this shines, because this is even safer than the clamp meter, because you don't have to energize your panels in order to test them. This already has a load built into it, and it can pull its own load. So in order to do this, we'll have to disconnect the positive for each string. Never do this when your panels are under load. Never. It even says right on the panels. Since these are connected in parallel, we don't have to disconnect each string on the negative side. We can simply plug our meter into the main negative and get our reading that way. Main negative. And then we're going to plug our positive into the end of the string on our first string. Did I just toast my meter? How many volts? I think too many volts, right? These don't handle that many volts. 60 volts, oh sh. Okay, so full transparency here. I just destroyed my meter. This meter has a voltage of 60 volts max, and three panels together is about 113 volts, so this meter is toast. Be mindful of that if you're going to get one of these.
Let's see what we got here. Hopefully you can learn something from my idiocracy. Nothing noticeable. Wait. Ooh, yeah, she smells. Okay, so yeah, look at that. That chip is smoked. You can see the burn mark on the PCB right there? Yep, looks like I'll be giving Amazon some more money. Well, it really sucks that I blew up my solar panel multimeter, but I have another one on the way already. So this meter will cost you about $130. It's actually the same price as a pretty decent multimeter. However, it is not a replacement to a multimeter. If I had to choose between buying a multimeter and a specialized solar panel multimeter, I would definitely choose to buy a regular multimeter. You'll get far much more use out of this than you would one of these. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if there's anything you think I left out, I think I covered everything pretty much. Let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching.